was a rematch of last year's championship, and it was certainly a nail biter. But in the end, the Texas Tech Red Raiders were crowned Big 12 champions on Sunday after topping Oklahoma State in the final matchup.
Here she comes. And it's out,
it's
folks.
Mine.
Fortune favors the bold.
The Red Raiders took the doubles point, but the Cowboys were able to bring it within one just before Felicity Maltby solidified the dub.
I mean, being up 40-love and then getting it to 40-30, obviously there's some nerves, but Todd was on the sideline just with trying to keep me calm, and I was just trying not to think about it, like forget about the nerves, and honestly, probably one of the greatest feelings I've ever experienced, like being able to come back from that and beat OSU this year after losing to them last year and representing the double T like that is just such an honor, and being able to bring back this trophy is so amazing.
To be in that moment, and as a sophomore, you're not in those moments. I mean, this was a home match for Oklahoma State with that crowd, and to have them all on top of her and for her to show that type of poise and to continue swinging out in the big moments, I couldn't be more proud of her and all of them, really.
With that win, the team earned both the regular season title as well as the championship title. It's the first Big 12 championship title in Red Raider history.
You know, winning the regular season was a big thing, but we'd never won a conference tournament title. We'd been here three times, and you know, and like Oklahoma said, Chris Young said, Oklahoma State, you know, they're the champions until someone knocks them off at the tournament.
The most outstanding performer was awarded to Gabby Talaba, who competed for the Red Raiders on the ones court and didn't drop a set all tournament.
Wow, that is a war. Tough weekend here for Liskova, losing the last two.
She's the best player to ever put on the Texas Tech Red Raider jersey. And so she deserves that award. She deserved that award whether our team won or lost. And, you know, for her to go through what she did to beat, in my opinion, you know, someone that could be the number one player in the country in Liskova, to do it on fast courts, which Liskova likes, you know, to show that resilience after getting absolutely pounded last time we played Liskova, shows how far she's come and how much ability she has.
And they aren't done yet. They find out their NCAA fate on Tuesday and will continue the rest of the postseason run in 2 weeks.
That's a tournament. I mean, that's a top 10 tournament team, round of 16 type matchup that you're going to have to face. And for us to face this again this early and get a test before the NCAA tournament, I think gives them a lot of momentum and a lot of confidence that when we're in that situation again, that they can pull it off.